When doing random sampling, the sample mean statistic is a consistent estimator for the population mean parameter. What does this mean? I'm not going to give the official definition. However, we can just intuitively think of it as X bar will do a good job approximating mu when the sample size n is large enough. Suppose x1 through xn is a random sample from a population with mean mu and variance sigma squared. Then the sample mean x bar, which equals 1 over n times the summation I goes from 1 to n of xi, is a consistent estimator for the population mean mu. We already know from a previous video that it's an unbiased estimator. The expected value of x bar is mu. The mean, the theoretical mean of the random variable x bar, which is a statistic, is equal to the population mean mu. To show consistency, what else do we need to show? We need to show that the variance goes to zero as n goes to infinity. How do we do that? We need to use properties of variances. The variance of x bar, first of all, can be written in terms of the summation as the variance of 1 over n times the summation I goes from 1 to n of xi. Now, the variance operator is not a linear operator, unlike the expected value operator. However, it still has some nice properties. One nice property is that this coefficient, this constant, can be brought out in front as long as you square it. 1 over n quantity squared is the same as 1 over n squared, so I can bring it out as a 1 over n squared times the variance of the summation. The expected value operator was linear. I could pull the summation out. Can I do the same thing with the variance? The answer is yes, but we do need the assumption that this is a random sample, which means these random variables are assumed to be independent. You can only pull the summation out of the variance operator when you assume your random variables are independent. We are assuming that here. So we can pull the summation out. We get 1 over n squared times the summation I goes from 1 to n of the variance of each xi. So that again is by independence. That's assumed when you have a random sample. Now what do we do? We need to use the fact that the variance of each xi is the same. It's sigma squared. Each of these is a sigma squared. Therefore, this becomes 1 over n squared times the summation of a bunch of sigma squareds. How many of them? N of them. So you get n times sigma squared. One factor of n cancels. You're left with sigma squared over n. And that definitely goes to zero as n goes to infinity. And that's what we need to show that x bar is not only unbiased, but also consistent. Intuitively, in terms of the sampling distribution of x bar, since x bar is unbiased, it will be centered on the population mean mu, and it will look like a normal curve when n is large enough by the central limit theorem. And then, the fact that x bar is consistent means that the variance and the standard deviation gets smaller and smaller as n gets larger and larger. So for a larger value of n, the sampling distribution of x bar will be taller and skinnier, still centered on mu, but we can expect the observed value of x bar to be closer to mu.